Now, in February 2015, Russia won the men's ice hockey gold at the Granada Universiade, but Sweden was competing in its second ice hockey tournament since making a comeback at Trento in 2013. That after a 45-year absence. This is where the Swedish Universiade comeback started. The Stockholm Royal University of Technology, and the instigator was a student. Joakim Ronneback Thompson is a student in industrial engineering and management, and in 2012 created the UHL, the first university hockey league in Sweden.
It has been a long night, you know, hard work. Volunteering for this league, but it's so fun, you know. You get so much back when you're skating out to on the ice, when you have you know, the crowd and the yelling, screaming, the university name, and you know, in some games here in Stockholm and in Lund, we have a crowd up against 400 to 500 people coming to every game. So that's pretty amazing, and we see a great interest in college sports here.
He came here the first year, he started the team here at the school, and the same time he started the UHL and got the game started with the universities here, and I think it's great. He's done a lot of work, and I don't know if the guys here in our team can imagine how much work he put into this and to get all this together, and we're so so glad that he got this all this energy to make it happen.
This is lots of volunteering work, of course. Every university creates their own home games. I try to manage the schedule, and we try to sell tickets to the games, to have some ice time and, you know, training sessions. Hopefully in the future we'll see UHL as an association with paid employees, and maybe from there we can develop it and try to really compete with the best nation in university sports.
The UHL allows Sweden to select its best players for international tournaments and face leading nations like Canada, the USA and Russia. Its future lies in recognition from the powerful National Federation of Ice Hockey.
We haven't yet recognized by the Swedish Ice Hockey Association yet, but that's something we have to improve and try to get them on board to increase the league. But so far it's so good. We have five universities participating this year, and last year four universities, so we try to develop the league all the time.
While studying at university in Sweden is free, there's a funding problem for the UHL in such a large country. Traveling from Chalmers in Gothenburg to Stockholm takes 6 hours by car, and that's short compared to a trip to Umeå in Lapland.
By train it's almost 20 hours, and by flight about 4 or 5. But we can't afford the flight, so it will. Hopefully, we can meet halfway somewhere in Sweden and play the game. But that's for the spring. We have to plan for that.
Right now, we don't have the economics to travel up to Umeå, and it's a real shame because I know some of the guys there, and they're gonna have a really good team. So I really hope we can pull it together and find a way to make this league a big thing in Sweden.
Now, in the UHL, players have to pay for everything themselves: sports equipment, travel, referees and rinks. For some universities, merely finding facilities can be tough.
Here in Gothenburg, it's very hard to find the stadium to play in. And we have worked very hard now and got some ice time for the UHL this year. Last year, we had to play in the spring after the season because it's full. Every stadium is full all the season.
Chalmers University are the UHL vice champion, but resources are thin. The team coach is also one of the players.
We had a lucky break that I'm injured this year. Lucky for them, unlucky for me. But we oftentimes you have to pick a player just to be a playing coach. This year I'm injured, so I stepped up and took the role.
Nevertheless, Chalmers students seem to have no regrets about spending so much time on the ice.
I think it's pretty good to have something on the side from the studies.
because you can keep the mind on something else. And when I train, I can stay focused for a longer period of time, in class and off class. Even though you stay in school like 8 hours a day, then you, even with exams, like you go down to the rink and like you can drop everything else, and you have 2-3 hours where you just don't think about that at all. So it's really good for like relaxation for the brain.
Sweden's UHL is getting more attention and has the support of the country's university sport federation.
It's a win-win situation. We have players on different level that will take part in ice hockey, physical activity. They will have sort of a social, it's good, I mean socially they can meet, they have sort of fun, and they can also be representing Sweden in the university.
A final word from Thompson at the KTH Royal Institute of Technology in Stockholm. The team captain has high hopes for student hockey, but is playing the long game.
Right now, we are not recognized by the Swedish Ice Hockey Association, and that's why we don't get funded from them. But hopefully in the future, they will recognize us, and then we can be a part of the association. And by that, we also get funded by them to participating in the Universitetsligan. But I don't think we can manage that to the 2017 university in Kazakhstan, but hopefully in 2019 we can manage it.
Student ice hockey on the rise in Sweden then. Look out for Thompson and his teammates in Almaty 2017.
Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders. International University Sports Federation brings together millions of students worldwide around the same values, excellence in mind and body. Thousands of students, hundreds of universities participate in FISU events, the rendezvous for the best student athletes. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.